Hi, good afternoon to all of you, my dear viewers, subscribers, mockers and blasphemers of God, stand bound to be tormented in hell. This is my video response to you, Amos Piano, for impersonating me. How hard can it be to be the preacher 8-4-0-4-0? Well, Mr. Muspiano, it is not really that hard. Anything that you do that comes from your heart, you do it because of love, you do it because of passion. Nothing is really hard, Mr. Muspiano. Yes, I've been preaching the words of God for more than 36 years now, and I do not regret doing it. One second do I do not regret. You know why? Because Jesus Christ died for my sins. He saved me. He changed my life. I could be in hell now. I could just be just one of you at these blasphemers and mockers of God. But God saved me. He changed my life. So therefore, it is an opportunity to serve the living God. And I will keep on doing this, Mr. Muspiano, until I die. But let me tell you this. I know what I'm doing. I know where I am going. I will be with my King. I have mansion waiting for me in heaven. I will be walking on that streets of gold. And these are heavenly crown, heavenly mansion, Mr. Muspiano. And I do not blame you if you cannot understand what I am talking about, because you are all too worldly, too materialistic. How can a man of Satan, children of Satan, understand about the things of God? I just pity all of you. Yes, you can keep on mocking me, keep on blaspheming me, but I'm telling you, it will do no good. It will never affect me. So therefore, you are just wasting your time. And you, Mr. P Channel, don't ever think just one second that I will be affected for what you are doing. And all I get is, you know why? Because I am determined to preach and to serve my Jesus until I die. So therefore, you are just wasting your time. Mr. P Channel, you want to stop mocking and blaspheming until I will go insane? Well, Mr. P Channel, you're just wasting your time, my dear Mr. P Channel. Okay, Abazim Madani, turn to Hala before it's too late, preacher. Abazim Madani, I will tell you this. All of you Muslims around the world, not one of you will escape the wrath of God. Do you know why? Because Allah cannot be God. Muhammad cannot be a prophet of God. Because there is only one God, the true God, the Almighty God. And that is Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Okay? Okay. Mr. Converdus, whose piano, Rhapmatic, Rivers on the Moon. This is my response. Why a person cannot repent once he gets to hell? Okay, Proverbs chapter 1, verses 24 up to 33. Well, let me just greet you, Mr. Winam 666. How come I do not see your comments anymore? I'm afraid you are now being burned alive in hell. I'm afraid you are now being tormented in hell, Mr. Winam 666. I hope you enjoy being burned alive in hell. I pity your soul. Because I am cold and you refuse. I have stretched out my hand and no one regarded. Because you disdained all my counsel and you ignored my rebuke and my correction and my counseling and instead laugh and mock me and blaspheme me. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your terror comes. When your terror comes like a storm and your destruction comes like a whirlwind. When distress and anguish come upon you, then you will call upon me, but I will not answer. So this is it, Mr. Convardos. So stop pulling yourself, all of you at ease. You are just pulling yourself. This is the problem with you, all of you at ease. You see, you love committing sin. You love your vices, your evil ways, your evil whims, your caprices. You do not like to turn to God. You do not like to repent. You keep on saying, how come God is not doing any compelling evidence for you to believe him? That is only your excuse. But in reality, you are evil, full of Satan. And you're expecting that once you get to hell, well, that's the time to believe that there is hell while you are being burned alive. And then you will come to God. You will ask for him, for his mercy. You will ask God's forgiveness because he is a loving God. He is a merciful God. And you're expecting that God will forgive you. No way, no way, no way. You will be in hell for eternity. All of you mockers and blasphemers. Blasphemers of God. Okay, you will seek me diligently, but you will not find me. Because you hated me and blasphemed me, and you did not choose me, nor serve and believe in me. Therefore you will reap what you have sown. You will die in your sin, and you will be tormented in hell forever and ever. This is it now, Convardos. Stop pulling yourself. You see, this is also your problem. You're becoming too ambitious. You know why? Yes, God is omnipotent. God is an all-powerful God. He can do what he wants to do. But no way he will force you to love him. No way! If you want to go to hell, then go to hell, all of you! Enough is enough! Being a blasphemer, mockers of God. I'm telling you this. Either you will repent now, or be born in hell forever. Oh my. Okay, Convardos. I would prefer living my own life to my own standards and be just of who am I. If God cannot accept that, then I wouldn't want to be in heaven. That will be full of false individuals. Look like God has limits to his powers. If his love and mercy has limit. Your Convardos. How old are you now, Mr. Convardos? Keep on pulling yourself, Mr. Convardos. That is only your excuse. If you don't like to go to heaven, then go to hell. I'm telling you now. Stop mocking God. Stop blaspheming God. Stop this foolishness. And go back to your senses that there is God. That there is indeed an almighty God, a creator of the universe. Before it will be too late, accept Jesus Christ now. Or be born in hell for eternity. Jesus Christ, the almighty God, the creator of the universe, repent!